You are overcomers. The Lord will turn your circumstances around you to favor you. In the name of Jesus, you are overcomers. You are overcomers. The Lord will turn circumstances around you to favor you. The Lord will turn your circumstances around you to favor you in the name of Jesus. Welcome once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you. Welcome once again for coming. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. This is Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Ontario, Canada. God bless you. I'm going to look the topic called War Against Poverty Activators. War Against Poverty Activators. Every time when you are blocked, you never smile and you will never be happy. Anytime when you are broke, you will never smile and you will never be happy. When you have nothing, you cannot be happy. When you are broke, always you cannot be happy. You cannot be happy. You cannot smile. Poverty will make people to look down on our God. Poverty will make people to look down on you, not even God. Poverty is not one of the promises of God for His people. Poverty is not one of His promise to people. God has never promised His children in poverty. Never. That poverty belongs to the enemy, the devil. Poverty will make doing the will of God difficult for many people. Anytime Jesus wanted food, He got it. If He was fasting, then He was fasting. So anytime Jesus wanted food, He got it. But if He was fasting, He was fasting. So, you don't have to fast because you don't have lunch or because you don't have food. Poverty most times delays the growth of a believer. When the person cannot even buy a Christian books and materials to help himself. I do get some emails, people writing to me and asking me to help them to get some Christian books or materials. Because poverty cannot allow them to have, even to afford to buy materials, even the Bible. That is how bad it is. So, poverty hinders evangelism. A lot of people cry day and night wishing they could contribute to the work of God, but they cannot because they do not have money. Wealth will be released to you even without you doing anything, or your money could become too hot for anybody sitting on it, and the person would have no choice but to release it in the name of Jesus. Yes, poverty can be released from the kingdom of wealth can be released from the kingdom of darkness. Where the wicked are sitting on your wealth, it is going to be released in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Poverty opens room for sickness and diseases. A lot of sickness and diseases would have been prevented if poverty was not in place. When God blesses you and you build your own house or you have your own apartment and you have a toilet the way you want it, then you do not have to share a toilet seats with 20 or 10 people. That could give you all kinds of infection. When you have your own apartment, you can share your, you can just use your own facility, everything, kitchen, toilet by yourself. But poverty can make you to share with the people in the bathroom, in the kitchen, everything. I remember when I used to live with somebody's room, we were sharing about 5 people in one room, in one apartment. And we were sharing toilet, kitchen. Some people are dirty, are not clean. Some people are stink. So you want to go to use the washroom, and somebody has went and put a very hot perfume there. So you wait, you feel so bad. But if it is you, you don't mind. Poverty can make you to live in a place where you can share a toilet, 20 people, even 5 people, even a large people. I have seen this. It is because of poverty. But when you have your own, when you have money, you buy your own apartment, you buy your own house, or you have your own place, it will be good. But poverty will make you to share people you don't know. Some people you don't know if they can go and portion your food. That's a work of poverty. But we thank God tonight. God is going to help us in Jesus' name. Poverty can be a source of serious temptation. Poverty can be a source of serious temptation. People are tempted even to divorce. People are ending up divorced because of poverty. Here is a man who does not have anything. When he comes home, the wife does not talk to him. He wants money, he wants food, but no money, nothing. So what will happen? They will start fighting. The man will become very violent. They will start fighting, and then they end up divorced, or the man will just decide to go wherever he wants to go. That's poverty. Poverty will make even children not to go to school, not have good clothes, not have enough. That's poverty. Now, when these children go to school and they see other children with the uniform, with the new shoes, with the books, and their children have nothing, they feel bad. That is how poverty is bad. But in the name of Jesus, I destroy every disgrace and shame that poverty has brought in your life in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are going to look in the book of Psalms 35, verse 27. The book of Psalms 35, verse 27. The Bible says, "Let them shout for joy and be glad that favor my righteous cause ye. Let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, which had pressure in the prosperity of his servant." Here is the good news. The Bible says, let them shout for joy. You know, when you don't have money, when you are broke, you can't even shout joy. You cannot, it is difficult. But the Bible is telling us, let them shout for joy and be glad that favor my righteous cause, the favor of righteous cause, ye. Let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, which had pressure in the prosperity of his servant. The Lord Almighty has pressure in prosperity of his servant. So God is himself is pressure. God is very happy when you are wealthy, when you have money, when you are rich. God is very happy for you. And they would like you to be wealthy, not poor, because poor does not belong to God. Jesus Christ died so that you can be. Jesus died poor so that you can be rich. That's what the Bible says. The Bible does not say that Jesus died so that you can be poor. He said he died so that you can be rich. Now, God says, rejoice. Let them shout for joy and be glad that favor may righteousness cause ye. Let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, which had pressure in the prosperity of his servant. So God is very, very, very happy when he sees his children prosper. His children, he wants to see children, his children prosper so that they can be able to worship him and glorify him and the joy and sound and be happy. When you don't have anything, it is difficult to even to open your mouth. But God is able today to break every poverty in your life in Jesus' name. The Bible says in Joshua 1:8, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein, for then thou shalt make thy way prosperous. The Bible is telling us that this book, Joshua 1 verse 8, this book of the law shall not depart out of the mouth. The book of the law shall not depart out of the mouth, but thou shalt meditate and tarry therein day and night. Thou shalt may observe to do according to all that is written therein, for then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Thou shalt have good success. This is the law of God. It is commanding us we should not leave the law of the book. We should not leave the law. The law of God, the promise of God, that God has promised us. God has have good promise that we are going to be prosper. He has said and he doesn't change. Our God is a God of promise. He never promises poverty. God has never promised poverty. The only problem is when you cannot think, when you think wrong mind and you cannot expect prosperity. When you think, when your mindset, you always think that you are poor. I know somebody, he was calling himself poor. I'm poor. All the time he called himself I'm poor. He died poor because you want to be poor. So let the Bible says, let the law of this book not depart from your mouth. Just confess, rejoice, say that I am rich. You don't have to think wrong. When you start thinking wrong things, rejecting, you start envious, jealousy, then poverty will not leave you. So you don't have to think wrong thinkings. Just believe God and trust Him. You will be there. Even though your situation is difficult right now, the Lord Almighty will change your circumstances around you to favor you. You are overcomers. Continue pressing on. The Lord Almighty, His promises are there for you that you will prosper. Not to be poor. You will prosper. You are overcomers. You will overcome every obstacle. You will overcome every poverty in the name of Jesus. In John 10:10, it says, the thief's purpose is to steal and kill and destroy. But my purpose is to give them rich and satisfying life. The purpose of God is to give you abundance, is to give you life, not to destroy you. Poverty is a destroyer. Poverty is a killer. Poverty is a destroyer. Yeah? That's why we must say poverty must die in the name of Jesus. Poverty is a killer. Poverty is a destroyer. Poverty it can steal your joy. It's a big thief. Poverty is a thief, is a criminal. It makes people want to steal everything from you. Poverty is not something that you can joke. John 10:10 describes poverty how it is. But the Bible says the purpose of the Lord Jesus Christ, He came to make you rich and satisfied in life. You must study prosperity, the word of God. the enemy will not command to destroy. If you start the word of God, the enemy will never command anything. He will never destroy it. He will try to destroy, but he will defeat it. When you start the prosperity, when did you sit down and study prosperity? Before time, I didn't know always. I was like the way Jesus said that the rich man cannot go to heaven. And now, because we were told in the church that the rich man cannot go to heaven. So I was saying, why should you be rich and you can't go to heaven? Many people, even some people, I was talking with one of my sister and my daughter in the Lord. She was just satisfied with what she doesn't want to be rich. She doesn't want to get more money. She wants to have that little money so that she can go to heaven. She doesn't want anything. So she was in box, living in a box, that she doesn't want anything. She doesn't want more than even $2,000. She wants to be under like $500 study seat so that she can go to heaven. I told her, no, that's not the Jesus. That's not the Jesus, what Jesus was meant. Yeah? So Jesus himself was wealthy. If you look at Jesus, he had money until he had a treasure who was Judas Iscariot, who was taking care of his park. He was a financial minister. He had 12 disciples working with him. So the Jesus was, if you look at it from the Bible, everyone, the priest, the prophets, were very wealthy. No one was poor. So I'm telling you that the enemy is a liar. You have to come out that mentality of believing that poverty, believing that the rich, but rich will not enter to heaven. The Bible says the love of money is the source of all evil. Once you love money than God, then that is evil. That is idols. You are worshiping money. But if you love God and you love money and love money late, that's not a problem, because money is good. Money answers everything. Money is good. I'm telling you. When you don't have money, you can't even smile. When you have money, you feel it good. You walk without even thinking of anything. You can do anything when you have money. But when you don't have money, I'm telling you, it's so bad. It's a disaster for you. You start fighting everybody. People fight everyone because of poverty. So I pray that God would deliver you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm sorry. Let me take water. God is good. 2 Peter 2, verse 1, 3 to 4. By his divine power, God has given us everything. 1 Peter 1, 3 to 4. By his divine power, God has given us everything we need for living a godly life. God has given us everything. We have received all of his by coming to know him, the one who called us to himself by means of his marvelous, glorious glory and excellence. Verse 4. And because of his glory and excellence, he has given us great and precious promises. These are the promises that enable you to share his divine nature and escape the world's corruption caused by human desire. You see, God has given us everything. That's what the Bible says. This is what the Bible says. Look at that. God has given us everything. God has given us everything, people of God. Hallelujah. God has given us everything. God is God. According, I want to, this is a King James. It says, according as his divine power had given unto us all things that pertain unto life and goodness through the knowledge of him that had called us to glory and virtue, whereby are given unto us exceedingly great and precious promises, that by this ye might be a partaker of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. Verse 4. Whereby are given unto us exceedingly great and precious promises, that by this ye might be a partaker of divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. Thank you, Jesus. God has given us everything. By his divine power, God has given us everything we need for living a godly life. So, things God has given us, nothing comes from heaven. Everything here on is here on earth. You see, God has given us everything. Everything is here. Money is here. Prosperity is here. Wealth is here. So, he has given us everything. But your enemy, the devil, Satan, he wants you to live in poverty. He wants you to live in miserable life. He's responsible for everything good that you have. We are one to pray that the Lord will destroy them. The Lord will destroy your enemy. Enemy of your activators shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. That's why we need to stand against we want to stand against war against poverty activators. The enemy that is activating your poverty shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. There are powers that is activating poverty in your life. No matter what you are doing, you are still going down. You never prosper. You came to this country. This country is opportunity. This country, even where you are in your country, it's an opportunity. But people are living there and people are wealthy. People are having big, big cars. They have houses. And you tried, but you have nothing. That is a demonic activator, poverty activator. That is activating you that nothing will come out of you. There's some powers that rising up wherever they see you with something, and they will fight until they take everything from you. So my God will destroy every poverty activators in your life in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, yes, you will prosper. You will never, never, never remain the same again. The Lord will turn your circumstances around you to favor you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians 9, verse 10. The book of 2 Corinthians 9, 10, the Bible says, for God is the one who provides seed for the farmer and then bread to eat. In the same way, he will provide and increase your resources and then produce a great harvest of generosity in you. So God is the one who provided a seed for the farmer and then bread to eat. May God provide you with the seed so that you can be able to plant and eat later. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. I'm reading 2 Corinthians, 2 Chronicles 6, verse 4. 2 Chronicles 6, 4, the Bible says, and he said, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, who had with his hands fulfilled that which he has speak with his mouth to my father David, saying that you will prosper. God has said, he said that it is his power to prosper. It is his power to get wealthy. It doesn't say it's the power of the devil. Devil does not have power. All the power, the devil has the satanic power to destroy your life. He has power, yes, but his power cannot defeat the power of God, which means it doesn't have any power. The power the devil is having is the power that he is having because he can manage to control you or to witch you or to do you evil. But once you know the power of God, the devil has no power over your life in Jesus' name. Because the Bible says it is his power. Devil can make you wealthy, but he gives you condition and a hard time. But God's power, it's not so. Therefore, the power of God is so powerful than any power in the world, than the powers of the devil. That's what you have to know. If the devil can be so powerful to do what he's doing, what about the Father, who is God, who is the owner, the resource of all powers? Yes, 2 Chronicles 25, verse 5. If they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasures. If they obey, only obey, and you will live and be enjoyed. Obey the word of God that God has never created you to be poverty. As that is not the promise of God. God's promise is to don't let the book of the road to part from your mouth. The promises of God is to you to be prosper, not poverty. God has good plans for you. The promises of God is said in Jeremiah 29 verse 11. He has good plans for you. The plans to prosper you, not to destroy you. That is his promise. He has good promise for you. Therefore, people of God, don't look down yourself. We have good news. We are going to destroy the powers of poverty in your life. Job 36 verse 11, the Bible says, if they obey and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pressure. But if they obey not, they shall perish by the sword. They shall die without knowledge. Job 36 verse 11, the Bible says, if ye by willing and obedient, ye shall eat the good of the land. You see, it's to be obeyed, to be obedient. You obey God, you will eat. That God never promised you to be poverty. Never promised you to be poor. God has not meant you to be poor. Isaiah 1 verse 19. The Bible says, you walk away God's way instruction, and it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken intelligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and do of his commandments, which he had commanded you these days, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth, and all those blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. So wherever you obey the Lord, you don't have to mourn. When you obey God the Lord, the promises, the blessings belong to you. And it will overtake you. And then the popular scripture that everybody memorizes and knows is from the book of Deuteronomy 28 verse 1 to 2. The Bible says, blessings of obedience. Now it shall come to pass, if you intelligently obey the voice of the Lord your God, to observe carefully all his commandments, which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all nations of the earth, and all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you, because you have obeyed the voice of the Lord your God. Once you obey the voice of the Lord of your God, the blessings will come and overtake you. We would want to pray against these poverty activators. Poverty must die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am want to pray that every altar of poverty in your place that is following you, every poverty in your place of birth, every poverty in your city. I was in New York and I visited a place called Brooklyn. Brooklyn is a place where black people lives mostly, or you can't see white people there. You only see black people. And the place looks really poverty. Looks so poor, the area. Even the roads, it's very dirty. It's not a nice place. That is a place where people are born, and there's a lot of criminals there. There's a lot of drugs, people living there. They are living under heavy poverty there. So that place, that village, somebody must stand up and rebuke that demons that is living people in poverty in that area. Wherever I say that those people cannot be prosper, so somebody must stand and rebuke that place. I know even here in Canada, there's some areas where it is poverty area. No matter what you can do, they will never be prosper. So there's some demon living there saying people of this community, they will never prosper. Therefore, I am taking authority. If you are living in such a place, I am taking authority by the power and the blood of Jesus. Let God destroy that place and burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. Where you are living, even the house you are living right now, if that house is the cause that has said you will never prosper, I am destroying that poverty in that house, in that building where you are living in Jesus' name. If it is generational poverty, that said that nobody in your family will prosper, let that generational curses, generational poverty die and be broken to pieces in Jesus' name. Every satanic priest ministering against your prosperity in any evil altar, land mad in the name of Jesus. Any priest, any pastor, wherever it is, evil priest, satanic pastors, fetish, psychic people who are holding your prosperity, let them run mad right now wherever they are in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, every strength and the power of every environmental altar upon your life, whether in the name of Jesus, every strength and the power of every environmental altar upon your life, whether in the name of Jesus. There are some strength and the power of every environmental altar. Environmental altar, they are saying that you will never achieve anything. Those altars, I destroy them. They are making you sad and miserable. You may think why you cannot have anything. You have been applying the jobs, you have been trying everything, but the environmental altar, they are denying your success. They are denying you. Therefore, I break those altars. I break the altars right now in the name of Jesus. Every environmental altar raising up against you, I command them to be weathered in the name of Jesus. I destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. Today, I raise up an altar of continuously prosperity upon your destiny in the name of Jesus. I am a rising altar of continually prosperity upon your destiny in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, every stronghold or mental and spiritual poverty in your life be uprooted by fire in the name of Jesus. Every stronghold of mental and spiritual poverty in your life be uprooted by fire in the name of Jesus. Any covenant in your life that is strengthening the stronghold of poverty, I break them. I break them. I break them. Any covenant in your life that is strengthening the stronghold of poverty, I break them. I break it. I break in the name of Jesus. Any covenant your forefathers made that nobody will raise up, nobody will prosper in your family, let that covenant be broken into pieces in Jesus' name. I break them and I set them a place. It is very bad. It is very sad that you walk like an elephant and eat like an ant. You work with the boss. You make the boss so wealthy, but you are just paid in a peanut. That is a lie. I break that covenant right now in the name of Jesus. I destroy the covenant of poverty. I destroy them. I break them in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. Every stronghold of poverty in the place where you are living right now, and in the place of work, a place in your town, I am destroying them. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Yes, thank you, Father. Every stronghold of poverty in the place of where you are living, the place where you are living right now, the place of work in your town that have refused you to prosper, let that power be destroyed. Let that stronghold of poverty be break into pieces. I break the stronghold of poverty in your place of where you are living. Right now, where you are living, that place where you are living, that stronghold of poverty, I break them. I break that poverty. I take the authority by the power and the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, I am now denouncing and break it in the name of Jesus. Poverty is bad. Oh Lord, create opportunities for these people to prosper today. Create opportunities, God. Give them ideas to move them forward in the name of Jesus Christ. Poverty must die. Any power of poverty operating in your life, operating in your family, die, 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 die in the name of Jesus. I cast poverty right now from your life in Jesus' name. I cast that poverty right now in the name of Jesus. Poverty activator, hear the word of God. I destroy you. I bind you. I cast you from these people in the name of Jesus Christ. Poverty is an enemy. It makes people to look down our God. It makes people to see you like you are nothing. Even if you talk, even if you say, they can't see anything. You can have knowledge, you can have good ideas, but because you are oppressed, you are squeezed by poverty, you can't do anything. People have good ideas, but they lack empowered. They lack money. Yes. And the wicked, they know how to sell their souls, how to steal from them until they get them finished completely. When the devil wants money, by all means, you will give him. But when God wants his tithe and offering, wants money, it is difficult because you don't have. If the devil wants money, by all means, you will give. If he wants 10,000 right now, you will get it and give it to him. It can cause accident, it can cause sick, it can cause death, it can cause anything for people to do for him to get money. But God is a loving God, and he has given you opportunity to fight these enemies. I bind and cast out every negative word enforcing poverty into your life. Any negative word enforcing words into your life, you become bitter. You become negative. You feel like you have lost everything. When you have those negative thoughts, then poverty cannot leave you. I pray that every negative word enforcing poverty into your life, let them be destroyed. I break them and I render them powerless. It is not one to manifest. It is not one to manifest in the name of Jesus. I cast them and I bind them. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Spirit of stinginess, spirit of stinginess, disappear from the life of these people. Spirit of stinginess, when the spirit of stinginess, you are so stingy. That's why poverty is. It makes people stink. People can stink like dead animal. That's poverty. Because the body has been very bad odor. Because of poverty, poverty smelling to people like dead meat, like dead person, and you are alive. You see, have you heard people who stink like that? The demon make you to stink, and you are alive. That is poverty. Let that demon be destroyed and be bind and be sent to the hellfire where the Jesus has want to send them in Jesus' name. Yes, thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I bind and cast out the spirit of disobedience in the name of Jesus. The spirit of disobedience, hear the word of God. I cast you and I bind you. I destroy you by the power and the blood of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. Where other people are spending money, I pray you that you will refuse. You will not spend money boil it by first in the name of Jesus. Yes. You know the evil, they make people to spend money anyhow. Where you go to the store, you wanted to spend $20, you end up spending $50 or $100. You buy things that are unnecessary, and these things, even you will throw them. Many people, they throw food. They go to the store and buy. I used to be like that. I used to go to the store, I buy. And then I can't eat them, I can't use of them, and they go bad. So you throw them. Check your fridge. Check those labels and see how many stuff that expires you are throwing. That's money. I was saying, look at this money. I bought these things, now I'm throwing it because it has expired. Now you lose money like that. Let God control you in the name of Jesus. You buy what you can finish. You don't store things that would steal your money. We have told we can store, yes, but there's no point of store things that would be expired and you lose money. Yes, Lord, thank you, Jesus. We have ATM. We have money. You leave that money in your card or somewhere. When the food is finished, you can go and get it. Rather than store food and they go bad and then you throw it. So you lose the money. There's no point at all. Buy 2 to 3 items that will last for the week. And then next week, go and do the buy. Don't buy the whole lot. And then it goes bad. Like you buy a lot of milk. And then you find that this milk, they have expired. You can't use it any, and you want to consume it. So it can be portioned to your body. You can't use anything expired. Therefore, people of God, I pray that God Almighty, that will control you and help you. That where people are spending money, you cannot be one of them. You cannot be the candidate of spending. That is the demon that is forcing you to do so. Let those demons be defeated in Jesus' name. Every evil machinery against your prosperity be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I destroy by fire every weapon of poverty targeted against your life in Jesus' name. I destroy by fire every weapon of poverty targeted against your life in Jesus' name. Poverty targeted against your life. Poverty targeted against your family. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil power sitting on your prosperity, paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Every evil power sitting on your prosperity, sitting on your wealth, I paralyze them in the name of Jesus. Every remote controlling machine fashioned against your destiny, be consumed by fire in the name of Jesus. I pray every remote controlling machine fashioned against your destiny, be consumed by fire of God. Let them be consumed by the fire of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Yes, my Father. I break every condition of poverty in your life. I break every condition of poverty in your life in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Pray like this. I break every condition of poverty in my life in Jesus' name. Break every witchcraft poverty in your life. Break them. Break every poverty in your over every witchcraft poverty. Witchcraft poverty, break them. Break them and curse of poverty, break it. Destroy it in Jesus' name. I destroy, I break and curse out and break and destroy every witchcraft poverty, every satanic poverty, every evil poverty. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. You stronghold of poverty, receive the fire of God, burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Condemn poverty. Condemn this demon of poverty. Condemn it. Condemn it. Refuse to be poverty. Say, poverty, hear the word of God. I condemn you. I destroy you. Get out of my life. Out in the name of Jesus. I am praying that let that poverty to run from your life and get out. You will prosper. I see people here right now. They are one to hold money they have never held. The door has been opened for you. Opportunities has opened for you. As we continue praying these prayers, you can speak loud, amen. Speak loud with your strength, amen, amen, amen. I break off every inherited poverty in the name of Jesus. every inheritance, poverty, I break you in the name of Jesus. I know there was this pastor. I sponsored him to the college, honestly speaking. I sponsored the pastor to the college, the Bible college. The pastor finished the Bible college. I was the one who sponsored him from his education, from education up to high school. From high school, he finished high school. I sponsored him to go to Bible college. Now, he became a pastor, and he was doing good. So suddenly, something happened. He was able to buy his own property, his own house, and his church was growing. So we were happy for him. Something happened. And then the church scattered and things started running, going down. He loses his land. Things just changed. Now his children is growing up. They're supposed to go to school. He can't afford to sponsor the children to school. He can't take his own children to school. He can't be able to pay the school fees. So he requested me money. So I said, it cannot happen. Because you remember I sponsored you. You have to work hard and sponsor your children. That is poverty. Poverty inheritance. Now, right now, as we are talking, his children did not go to school. His son missed the school and he passed very well. He didn't go because he was not able to pay the school fees. Now, when I found that, I felt bad. I said, this is inherited poverty. When I check him, I found his father, his mother, from that his background, that the poverty is just high way. It's very bad poverty in that family. So it is a pattern of poverty. A whole pastor. Now I had to call him and pray with him and tell him, you have to change the prayers. You have to go back to deliverance prayers because he is not following our prayers. I was telling him, he said, no, these prayers, I don't like them. It's witchcraft prayer. Jesus said, love your enemy. So I said, okay, that's fine. You just do whatever you want to do, but the truth of the matter, you need deliverance. Yeah? So today I was talking to him. I bless him. So God was telling me to help him. He was happy, he was very happy now. He can smile. I'm telling you, poverty is bad. If you are a poverty heritage, poverty is bad. Even if you have something today, tomorrow you will lose everything. That's why you see people losing their property, houses, cars, and they remain without anything. It is health and poverty. I break them. I destroy them. I bind them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. In health and poverty, I destroy you. I render you powerless. Get out of these people in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. Every stigma of poverty in your life, be ripped up by the blood of Jesus. Be ripped up by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every adjustment of humiliated you, I rebel, I command you to rebel against you. In the name of Jesus Christ, let it be rebelled against you. Let poverty rebel against you. Let poverty refuse you and reject you and let it come out from your life in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I plead the blood of Jesus Christ. Yes, my Father, in the name of Jesus, every spiritual chain of slavery upon your life, break by fire. Break. Every spiritual chain of slavery upon your life, break in the name of Jesus. Break by fire. Break by fire. Every spiritual chain of slavery upon your life, break by fire in the name of Jesus. Every chain of inheritance failures upon your life, break by fire. Break in the name of Jesus. Let every seed of generational poverty dry up in the name of Jesus. Every power attacking your finances, every power attacking your work, every power attacking the sources of your income, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I destroy them. I bind them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. Every power attacking the sources of your income, every power attacking the sources of your income, let this power be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I bind them and I render them powerless in Jesus' name. Oh, yes, Lord. I pray that God Almighty, who is God Jehovah, to open your ways, to provide you. You know, the Bible says in Corinthians that it is the Father who gave you a seed to sow. Let God give you a seed. Let God give you a seed to sow in the name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I command stronghold of inheritance poverty in your life to be pulled down by the blood of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my God. Jesus, I thank you, Father. I love you, God. I give you the glory, Jesus. Oh, yes, my God, I want to thank you. Holy Ghost, arrest. Holy Ghost, arise. Arrest. Holy Ghost, arrest all poverty in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of poverty, let Holy Ghost arrest every spirit of poverty in your life. Let Holy Ghost arise, arrest every poverty in your life. Holy Ghost, arrest every poverty in your life. Anything that is making you to be poor, anything that is making you poverty, let Holy Ghost fire, arrest them. In the name of Jesus, many people, they are living under poverty, under poverty activator. The enemy is activating poverty. They have money, but for no reason, the enemy is holding them. The enemy is sitting on your money. I command them to vomit them. I command them to release them. That your job, that your work, that they have been sitting on your money. They don't want to release. They make you suffer. Make you to borrow, make you to suffer so much. I command them to release your money, to release your finances in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God will open door that no demon of hell that will close it in Jesus' name. I pray that God will give you opportunity to start business that no one else has the same business. I pray that God will create a new activities, opportunities for you to do something. And you are unique, that will bring income, will bring money. I pray that let the blessings, as the Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy 28 verse 1 and 2, that the blessings of God will overtake you and overcome you. You will be overtaken by the blessings of God. You will be the blessings of God will overtake you. The Bible says that it will overtake you, even you cannot have the place to keep it. In the mighty name of Jesus, call me if you want me to activate you now. A poverty activator has been taking place. Now I want to activate. I want to destroy and command them to come out in the name of Jesus. Call me. I will pray with you. Call me and I will teach you and show you how to get out of poverty in the name of Jesus. I will stand with you and break that demon that has been affecting your life. You will overcome us. Once you become a cover of overcomers, you will never be the same. Every members of overcomers, I have been promising you all the time. Many, no one will be poor. Like early churches, no one was lucky. Everybody was wealthy. Early churches, look at the book of early churches, the book of Acts. The apostles, no one lacked. They were in one spirit. They could go and sell their property and bring money to the house of God, to the feet of the apostle. Those criminals who were having wrong attitude, thinking wrongly, the spirit of God killed them. So the enemies that is opposing you, that would hinder you from prosper, the Lord will kill them instantly in the name of Jesus. Like there's some powers that does not want you to go to move forward. So call me, I will pray with you and stand with you. You will never be the same again. Your life will change. You are overcomers. Your life will change completely. You need the overcomers cover. I am here to cover you. My sister Lindy is in Africa. We send her there to represent overcomers in Mozambique, South Africa, and Malawi. She's there and she will come next month. God is using her mightily because she went with our cover. And no demon will touch her. No witchcraft will touch her. That's how it is. Once you become a cover, once I cover you, no demon will touch you. That's why you need to become partners to us. If you want to the cover, you want to become a partner, go to our website. www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca and look at the pattern called request. Just write your request there. Say, I want to be partner with you. What can I do? Then I will tell you what to do. So you become a partner. You are covered. You have a spiritual mother who will be responsible and take care of you. Some of you, you are like orphans. You have no parents. You live like orphans. You need a parents to look after you, to take care of you. Yes. Call us. Call me. I'm here. Our number is 647-608-5207. Or you can reach us in this under our landline, 905-487-7196. I thank the man. There was a man from States, I think Texas. This man is not in Periscope, he's in YouTube. He has been listening our prayers. He has been listening our prayers, all the prayers. He has been following me all the time. God has blessed him. He never called me to pray because he felt that this prayer is helping. He donated. He sent his donation. I will thank him so much. I'm going to call him tomorrow and thank him. I went to the post office. When I opened the post office, I found a big check. He just appreciating what God is doing. That's God we serve. So if you want to become a partner to overcome as deliverance and healing ministry, so that you can get a cover wherever you are in the world, call me. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca, and request, send a request. Send that I want to become a partner. I want to donate. I want to do this. What can I do? I will show you what to do. You need a cover. Poverty activators is very serious. When you don't have a cover, you will suffer. You will suffer so much. May God help you that you will come out from that poverty. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. My Father and my God, I want to thank you. I thank you, Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I am praying that every poverty that is rising up against your family, that is rising up against you, that is rising up, there is powers called poverty rising up. Very serious. They take even the little you have. That's how bad it is. I dismantle them. I dismantle every demonic opposition to your prosperity in the name of Jesus. I dismantle every demonic opposition to your prosperity in Jesus' name. Every satanic river of poverty and failure, clear off by fire. I command them to clear off by fire, to clear off every poverty of every satanic river of poverty and failure. I command you to clear off by fire. Let it clear off by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. I thank you, Father. You are a great God. I pray that God will deliver you in the name of Jesus Christ. Every altar of poverty prepared by your ancestors, break now in the name of Jesus. Break, 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 break. Poverty prepared by ancestors. Ancestors. Let them be broken to pieces. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray that poverty shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. Poverty follows. Poverty that is following you. I'm not your candidate. You poverty, leave me. Leave me. Leave me, poverty. I put you in my feet. Get out of my life in Jesus' name. That's when you talk to poverty. You have to cry and speak loud. Condemn that poverty. Speak loud. These prayers, it is one to destroy so much, so many powers of poverty in your life in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. Every witchcraft assemble in your neighborhood, I command them to be scattered by Holy Ghost fire. Let them be scattered. Let them be scattered. Let them be scattered by Holy Ghost fire. In the name of Jesus, scatter, 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 scatter in the name of Jesus. Let it stop on stronghold of poverty in your place of birth. Mention your place of birth. Any poverty, any strong man of poverty in your place, if it's Jamaica, America, wherever where you are, you messing it, you say, I destroy you. I destroy you in the name of Jesus. Every strong man of poverty in Brampton, here in my city, I destroy you in the name of Jesus. I destroy you. You will not function. You will not prosper in my life in Jesus' name. You condemn them. You destroy them in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. Every covenant made at your birth and the place of birth, you know there's covenant. When you are born, the wicked people will say some words over you that they are greeting you, they are happy you are born, but they will speak negative word. Those words they speak to you, I destroy them. I command them, they will not prosper. They will not stand. They have been attacking you. They have been living in you. But now the good news is that let God destroy them. Let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my God and my Father, I want to thank you, God. I want to bless your name. I give you the glory, God. Love you, Father. You are good, God. You are so wonderful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Call me. I will pray for you. Call me. I will attack the enemy of poverty in your life. You shall be free in the name of Jesus. Let me tell you, me personally, my background, I was born a place where was poverty. We were very, very poor. Very poor. Poverty, very bad. Yes. So, I refuse. I will never be poor. I refused. I said, if there's anything I can do, I'll do it. But I will never be poverty. I will never be poor. And that's exactly what happened to me. I refuse it. I said, I will never, 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 never. I was cursing, and I didn't know this. I didn't know the prayer. I was not a Christian. But I choose to refuse. No, 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 no. This is serious. How can other people are better doing well, and me, I'm not doing well? What is that? Yes. Why? Why should you paying somebody's mortgage and you can't pay your own mortgage? Why? Why should you be under heavier poverty? Everything is loan, 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 loan. You can't have anything. You get money, you pay, you remain with nothing. I have a sister who is almost committing suicide, who is feeling very bad because she can't enjoy her money. She doesn't have even 5 cents. Wherever she works, all our money goes to debt, because that is what the enemy has put her like that. Why? That is a great enemy. I stand against those powers. I stand against them. I break them. I break them. I break them. I destroy them. If you are that type of a person, call me. I will pray for you. I will stand with you and pray. I used to live in somebody's house. We were sharing, as I said, Abby. And then I said, why? Why should I share with somebody's house? Why, God? Why should I stay in people's house in a room? Why? Why should I share with the people in kitchen, toilet, God? And I am your child. And you are wealthy, God. I can't live such a life. I refused it. I say, God, you have to change this immediately. I cannot live such a life anymore. I was like mad. I really cursed. I cursed. And then the Lord opened for me. I got my house. I got a house. I got my apartment where I am happy, enjoying my fridge, my everything. I don't share with anybody. You can't live such a life. Yes, you can even have your own apartment, but you are paying somebody's mortgage. You need to have your own house, your own home. You need to have your own property. Why should the child of the devil enjoy all this and you, a child of God, you are under that poverty? That is a lie. You have to be very serious. You have to think and say this. No, 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 no. This cannot happen. This. Not with me. Not with me. Say not with me. This poverty must die. Curse it. Refuse to eat. Speak to God. Call me, join us. We'll pray with you. You cannot work so hard and you can't enjoy your money. You don't have anything, nothing. When you get your paycheck, it goes and you remain nothing. And then you start going to money store, stores, money mart, where people, the bank cannot run you because your credit is so bad. Then this money mart also, they give you money, and then they come to you, they call you, they take everything, because you have to sign that they will take money from your account. They take money, that money before you pay your debt, they have taken it. So you remain nothing. I pray that God will deliver you. Your life is going to change. Tonight, your life is going to change. By the power and the blood of Jesus, I destroy poverty in your life. I destroy the spirit of poverty. I destroy witchcraft poverty in your life. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. I bind them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. Go to our website and write the request. If you need to be partner with the Overcomers, Deliverance and Healing Ministry, write the request. Request. And if you need a cover, I will cover you in the name of Jesus. If you need a cover on anywhere in the world, I am here to cover you and stand with you. You must come out of poverty. You must come out of that curse that has been pressed on you in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Father, I thank you. Jesus, I thank you. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. God bless you so much. Call me. If you want me to stand with you against the spirit of poverty activator to destroy this enemy that's attacking you, call me. My number is 647-608-5207. 647-608-5207. Call me. I will stand with you. I am here to pray with you. In Jesus' name. Thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye. Bye-bye to you. God bless you. Have a wonderful day, or morning, or night. God bless you so much. See you tomorrow night. Midnight, 12 midnight. See you tomorrow, midnight, 12 midnight. Our time, Eastern time. Wherever you are in the world, check. Then you see. The same time you join, come. We'll be praying. We need God to do something about it, about this poverty. I'm going to continue tomorrow from here. We need to finish this topic. God willing, we'll be able to finish in Jesus' name. So join us tomorrow. By the four nights, we'll be doing this poverty thing. By four nights, your life will never be the same again. I am going to call jobs for you, better business for you. I'm going to call better business, better jobs. So you join us. Invite your family. Invite your friends. In Jesus' name. Thank you so much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye.